Thanks for listening to Dena Dons Radio, the hottest internet station on the planet.
All right, it's Sunshine Underground, Dena Dons Radio. I'm back in the studio. It's Big Brook. Today, I have the pleasure of speaking with the comedian Heather Hatton. How are you doing today, Heather?
I'm doing fantabulous. How are you?
I'm doing real good. Thank you so much for your time and calling in. I really appreciate you. Now, you're calling in representing Houston, Texas, and they call you the sexiest bitch in comedy. Why do they call you that, Heather?
I think they call me that because of the way that I look, of course. I don't look like a typical female comedian. My body is real, but, you know, I take care of myself. You know, like, I work out, so I have thighs, and my butt-to-thigh ratio is actually real. You know, I'll take care of myself, but, you know, most comedians don't look like that, like you.
Absolutely.
When you think of female comedians, you never think of a sex symbol.
No doubt.
I just think that's where it comes from.
Absolutely. I've seen the pictures. I've looked at the comedy shows. Heather Hatton is definitely one of the sexiest women in comedy, so go ahead and check her out when you get a chance. You can follow her on Twitter at Heather Hatton, HEATHERHATTON. Now, she's representing Houston, Texas, as I mentioned. What was it like growing up there, Heather?
I actually had fun. I was raised more of a... I went to all-girls school. I ended up getting kicked out of there and ended up graduating from Madison, but I was in private school. I was a gymnast. Trained under Bella Coloni. I played the violin. I was a pianist. So, although I'm from the country, my parents just exposed me and my sisters to different things that's not your typical black family stuff. So I think that's why my outlook on life is different.
For sure, for sure.
So,
shouts out.
I had fun. You know, it's hot here.
Yes.
You know, other than that, I had fun. I don't have any regrets in my life.
Okay, yeah, I've been to Houston. It gets very humid there, really, really hot and steamy there. And shouts out to Madison High School. For those of you that are familiar, that's in Texas. Shouts out to Madison High School doing their thing. On the line right now with Heather Hatton. My name is Big Brook. It's Sunshine Underground, Dena Dons Radio. Now, Heather, a few years ago when you were coming up, you wanted to be a model at one time. What changed your mind about becoming a model?
I was often told I was too short. Because I'm 5'3", so I was often told I was too short. So I was like, okay, you know, and at that time, it is still the same way. Well, no, not the same way now, but, you know, they was like, oh, you know, we have to use you if we need a petite model. But, you know, most models start at, like, 5'9" and up. Even with heels on, I'm just 5'5", so...
For sure. That would be 2-inch heels, though, right? You got to throw on maybe some bigger heels because you're 5'3", right?
Yeah, but, you know, when you were an athlete, right, you put on track, all kind of stuff. You know, we're not really that girly girl. We wear a lot of heels and stuff. So I was like, okay, that's not my calling. Whatever.
No
and
doubt.
Moved on with it.
Absolutely, absolutely. And you moved on and you're doing well. You dropped the CD called Heather Hatton Live in 2016. What inspired you to make that CD?
You know what, I actually asked God to give me creativity and think outside the box and to do a lot of things that maybe other comedians don't do. But, you know, my goal was to one day, I think I was watching the Grammys or something, and they had somebody in the comedian one, and I was like, what? You can win a Grammy in the country? All I need is an album? Oh, shit. Okay. So that's what made me do it. So that's eventually my goal, is to win a Grammy.
Okay.
Best comedy ever.
Absolutely. Shouts out to the Grammy family. Shouts out to Heather Hatton. She's 5'3" of comedy. She's very sexy lady. She's representing Houston, Texas. Now, how long have you been doing stand-up comedy? Okay, 5 to 10 years in the comedy industry. What comedians inspire you?
What comedians? You know, it is so funny because when I tell people that, they look at me like I'm crazy. Like, I was a big fan of Andrew Dice Clay. Because, you know, his company was kind of raw and edgy. And it's like, if you like him or you don't. Of course, I like Eddie Murphy. But Esther, I forgot her real name. But Esther, the comedian on Saturday Night.
Okay.
Yeah, I like her. I kind of like Chris Rock. But, and I'm a fan of Whoopi as to how she's more of a comedic actress. Because sometimes you're a comedian and not an actress. But then it takes a lot to be a comedic actress. Take on a serious role and a funny role and still be a comedian. So I'm a fan of her with her art. You know how she's very diverse.
For sure. For sure. Shouts out to Whoopi Goldberg, Chris Rock, Andrew Dice Clay, Eddie Murphy, and Esther. Shouts out to Esther too, doing it real big. Those are all some comedians that we're all familiar with and do a great job. Now, when you're doing your job, do men distract you from focusing on your career? How do you balance the men in your life being a sexy lady as far as in your career at the same time?
Listen, how can I say that? I would say no. Sometimes they're distracted, sometimes they're not. Actually, this last time, I thought I was going to go hard. Like I had to have a talk with my publicist and go, okay, I'm going to go hard. And then I actually asked God for me to be with someone that supports my career and who realized that how I look on stage. I mean, it's a part of me because that's how I look normally because I stay at the gym. You know, at the gym, most of it happens anyway. But, you know, that God still give me discipline and focus on my career and not put his feelings into consideration about, you know, when I go on stage or when I have to travel and do the show. So, I think I better have a handle on it. I think sometimes I've come to the conclusion that sometimes men can want the illusion of you until they get with you and see what it is.
Okay.
And sometimes they can't handle it,
Okay. Absolutely. Absolutely. I'm on the phone right now with Heather Hatton. Everybody go to Instagram and follow her, R-E-A-L Heather Hatton. That's the real Heather Hatton. The website is also www.realheatherhatton.com. There you'll be able to find all her comedy CDs and be able to follow up with her and get in contact with her directly. And thank you very much for your time. She's representing Houston, Texas. She's 5'3". She's the SBIC. Now, do you find it is harder being a female comedian versus male comedian? How do you, what's your take on that?
I used to find it harder until I had to put my foot down in various ways in my career. I don't think men get as many sexual propositions as women do. I'm not going to say all women, I just know I did. Until that's why I have to get a manager so they can have a middle person. I really think that's like the only difference. Women get approached more sexually than men do. As far as I actually had one promoter tell me, oh, I can offer you extra stage time if you let me hit. I'm like, what? What did you say? I'm like, what?
Right.
I can't believe he said that. And then he said, well, how do you think Monique made it? I said, I don't know how she made it, but I know you ain't finna tell me you slept with Monique. Because if that's the case, she left you behind, right? What you mean?
Yeah.
So that kind of thing. Really, after that was when I got a manager so I could have a middleman. But, yeah, you're going to be amazed at some of the stuff that folks.
For sure, for sure. Shouts out to Monique, though, doing her thing. She did have a residency here in Las Vegas at the SLS. And currently in Las Vegas, you can see Lunel. Lunel is in Las Vegas right now, too. I think she's working with Jimmy Kimmel. Okay. So shouts out to Lunel as well as Jimmy Kimmel. Yep. It's Unsigned Underground, Dena Dons. This is an exclusive interview right now with Heather Hatton. Now, Heather, at one time you slowed down on your comedy and you opened up a club. What type of club was it?
I had a strip club.
Oh, cool. That's real cool.
Yeah, I had, on some days it was a strip club, and on other days it was like a real club. So, you know, it was just the same location, same thing going on with it.
Okay. Yeah, that's a good place to have a strip club. That was in Houston?
Yeah, it was in Houston on the north side.
Okay, I could dig it. Shouts out to North Side Houston. And you also opened a liquor brand at one time. How was that journey?
It takes a lot to open up a liquor brand. You know, you have to get stuff passed and trademark, and CABC has to approve a lot of stuff. So I'm still actually going through that process.
Okay, no problem. Now, have you ever appeared on any television shows or any plays that we might be familiar with?
Back in the day, I did some stuff with BET, like they still had, what was that, Comic View or something?
Uh-huh.
And it's so funny because I actually learned about production and the budget. I was actually in two movies, but because they ran out of production, I mean, because they ran out of money for the budget, you know, the film was never edited, released, post-released, all that kind of stuff. So, not anything major that you can see me in right now. I mean, you can Google me all day and see all kinds of stuff pop up about me, but not anything currently, but I am working on some stuff that's in the project that the theater is real
soon. Okay, that's very cool. Now, your publicist is named C.C. Vance, Vance Publishing, NYC. How did you meet C.C. Vance?
Oh, my God, it's so funny how I met C.C. Actually, my manager at the time, we was looking for a publicist, and at that time, she was doing those publicists. And we reached out to her, you know, C.C. makes you do an interview. She just don't sign any old body. So that's how I ended up working with her. She was like, you know, I've never worked with a comedian before, but I would love to, and I see where you're going, and yeah. So that's how I met her, because she was on Slim
Thug's
information at that time as a publisher. So we reached out to her, and that's how we found her.
Okay, that's what's up. Shouts out to C.C. Vance, Vance Publishing NYC. Shouts out to Slim Thug. I'm on the line right now with the real Heather Hatton, not the fake one. Twitter, at Heather Hatton. Website, www.realheatherhatton.com. They call her the sexiest bitch in comedy. When you see the pictures, you'll agree. She was voted that with the likes of ladies like Sarah Silverman and others. She's the only African-American on the chart, so shouts out to Heather Hatton for being voted one of the sexiest women in comedy. Now, who are some of the comedians that you frequently work with?
I work with J. Anthony Brown. What's the other one? Oh, Dena Dons Productions. She's really funny. Tori?
Oh, okay.
Joe?
Guy and Joe Torrey?
I get them confused. Yeah, but the bigger one is Joe. Yeah, the smaller one is Guy. Him. And I worked with some other ones. Terry Grossman. I worked with him here in Houston. Walker? Something like that. I'm forgetting his name. She's happy hair. He's a comedian as well. So I've worked with some of those moguls here, and like I said, I think I worked with J. Anthony Brown twice here in Houston. The first time he was going to see me, and then the second time he actually requested me, so I like that.
That's
so
dope.
It's nice for me to be requested.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah. But you know what, because I was just going through some pictures. I just did the Alabama Music Awards in July, so, and I know that was televised. But I actually had fun doing that Alabama Music Awards. And I know that was televised on that table network down there in Alabama.
Okay. Shouts out to Alabama. Yeah. Shouts out to J. Anthony Brown, Guy, as well as Joe Torrey. I think Joe Torrey was in a movie with Tupac called Poetic Justice back in the day. And that was one of my favorite movies. He played Tupac's friend, and I think they drove up to the Bay Area at one point. And he got into a fight with Tupac in the movie Poetic Justice with Janet Jackson. So, shouts out to Joe Torrey.
Oh, okay.
Shouts out to Guy Torrey, as well as J. Anthony Brown. Shouts out to Alabama. Now, I know you travel a lot doing comedy. What are some of the places besides Alabama and Houston that you've traveled to?
Let's see. I know next year I'm supposed to be in California. I've actually done some things. In around Houston, like in the Dallas area. Let me tell you. Actually, last year I was supposed to go on tour to, like, in Las Vegas and New York, but some things happened. I wasn't able to go, but I can say maybe Houston, Alabama, and I think I have another one. I don't keep up with my schedule, my assistant do, but the devil's kind of up north. But they, oh, my God.
Yeah,
thank you.
Oh, yeah.
I be forgetting I have so much stuff going on.
Yep.
Yeah.
And that leads me right into that.
I'm performing this Saturday here in Houston. So I'm kind of,
For sure. Now, you say your son is about 10 years old, right?
Yes. Uh-huh.
How do you balance being a mother, being a good mother, and then balancing that with your comedy career? Okay, that's what's
up. Now, you know, I took him with me when I did Essence. I did Essence Festival, not last year, but the year before. I was on the Essence, and that's kind of when he saw me getting dressed. He was like, wait a minute, mama might be somebody. of course he can't come to a show, but he's never been to a show. But, you know, I dress kind of differently on stage, and he doesn't like that, so... But he does understand when I dress that way that, you know, mama going to work, I'll be back late on. By the time I get back late on, you better be asleep. Something like that. But he sees the way I dress, but he doesn't know. He hasn't grasped it. Like, people look at mommy as a sex symbol. But I handle it okay.
Okay, that's good. That's good. I'm glad you're able to manage everything. I'm on the line right now with Heather Hatton. She's the sexiest bitch in comedy. She's from Houston, Texas. She's been doing comedy about 5 to 10 years and worked with some big-time people like J. Anthony Brown, Guy, and Joe Torre. She dropped a single on May 1st called Fellatio. Everybody can go check for that. It's available right now on iTunes. What inspired you to make that one?
Living, you know, so I was just like, okay, I just got to doing this comedy album. Let me just hit this note one time. I didn't know that I was trying to release it as a single or whatever, but I mean, it is what it is. Now, my comedy album has actually done well. It was number one in Canada on the iTunes chart. So that's good. Like, you know, I was the first black woman to ever be number one on a comedy chart, period. So that was actually good for me.
Okay.
But I don't know, I was just like a semi in the studio. I didn't know they was recording me, and yeah, that's what happened.
Yeah, absolutely. That comedy album that reached number one in Canada on the comedy charts, was that the Heather Hatton Live, or is that a different one?
No, that's the Heather Hatton Live. Uh-huh.
Okay, congratulations. Yeah, that's a big deal.
That was actually doing good. I'm probably going to release another one.
Okay. All right. It's Unsigned Underground Dena Dons. Heather Hatton's on the line. The name of her album, Heather Hatton Live, came out in 2016. It's going down. It's topping charts in Canada. Heather, thank you for your time. I'm not going to take up too much more. Can you review your contact information with us?
Yes. My Instagram is Real Heather Hatton. My Facebook fan page is the same thing, Real Heather Hatton. You can also contact me on
Okay, no doubt. Did you want to give any shout outs while I got you on the line? Sure. Shouts out to CC Vance. Shouts out to Heather Hatton. It's Unsigned Underground Dena Dons interviews. Another one's in the books. Make sure you follow her, the sexiest bitch in comedy, Heather Hatton, therealheatherhatton.com. Thank you so much for your time. I hope you have a good day.
Thank you. You too.
All right, now.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Thanks for listening to Dena Dons Radio, the hottest internet station on the planet.